we studied what's called the epigenome. That is chemical information that's involved in allowing the genome to be expressed or not expressed. In this study, we created maps of the various human organs to understand their epigenomes, particularly what's called DNA methylation. You can think of the genome as the hardware of the cell, like computer hardware. You can think of the epigenome as the software. You need to run the epigenome software to read out the hardware, the genes in the genome.
It's been known for a long time that all the cells, or most of the cells in your body, have the same genome. But as is readily apparent, they all do different things. You know, your heart cells are different than your liver cells, are different than your lung cells, and on and on. The epigenome is kind of the tags or markers in a cell that define its state. So, you know, I'm a heart cell and I have these heart-specific markers, or I'm a lung cell, I have gene A and gene C on, things like that.
So basically, we collect a bunch of human tissues from four donors. And then we compare the demethylation in one tissue against the other and try to profile all the variations across the tissue types that we have and the donors we have.
So when we analyze these data, we take, you know, just a sample from a whole organ, and that's a really complicated mixture of cells. You know, your heart is made up of a lot of different types of cells doing different things, and we just kind of get an average signal when we're looking at these data. So what would be really cool is to try and separate out each of the individual cell types in your heart and actually look at the map for those, a particular kind of cell. And I think we could find some really interesting things in there.
So understanding the epigenome will help us to understand, for example, its role in cancer, which we know there is already an importance of epigenetic modifications in cancer, but we know very little about other disease states. So having these maps will help us to try to understand the role of some of these things, such as DNA methylation, in other kinds of diseases, or even in normal aging.